Thank you, everyone, for having me here today. I'm Alex Johnson. I'm running for Georgia GOP chairman. For those of you who don't know me, I've been involved in politics in Georgia for a long time. Since 2003, I was involved in the College Republicans at Oglethorpe University. In 2009, I was involved in my local party in DeKalb County. In DeKalb County, 2010, I ran for state senate in the Democratic district. I got about 43% of the vote there. I was chairman of the DeKalb County Young Republicans. I was legal counsel at the DeKalb County Republican Party. I've run for chairman of the state party a couple times before, in 2013 and 2015. All that information is available online at advancedgop.com. It talks about everything since then. I've been advertising to the state, letting people know exactly what's been going on in Georgia politics, the things going on in the party, and trying to get more people involved. I think that what we need to be doing moving forward in Georgia is we need to focus on the credibility of our brand, growing county parties, and definitely fundraising. When it comes down to the credibility of our brand, the only reason people are going to be involved in the Republican Party and get involved in GOP and in local chapters is if we're credible, if we're out in public doing something and doing things on the state level, putting out advertisements, getting people involved, letting people know what the Georgia Republican Party stands for. We have over 2 million Republican voters in Georgia in this last presidential election, and people need to know we exist. And that will help us grow county parties. Growing county parties is vital. Turnout is getting low, and we need people to be on the ground working hard to get people elected. And the state party needs to be providing services to voters and to the county parties in order to make the state stronger. We lost Cobb and Gwinnett counties this year to Hillary Clinton. That's not a good thing. Those are heavily Republican counties historically, and the current trends, we need to be fighting harder. And by doing those things, we can definitely start raising money, more money. Because right now, if you look at the Georgia GOP finances, it's about $260,000 more owed than cash on hand. That's a state Republican Party. You can find all the information about that on the FEC website, fec.gov. Shows every donation in, every expenditure out. And the real underlying point is, why are we raising money? What is the money going to be used for? Is it going to be used for this elite political insider consultant class? Or is it going to be used to grow the grassroots? Will it be used to get more people involved in the GOP? Because again, over 2 million Trump voters in this last election. The question is, how many are involved in the GOP, and are we going to be able to expand the number involved in order to expand our donor base? So with that, I'd appreciate your vote. Please check out advancedgop.com. It shows everything from the past 4 years. Very transparent. You know exactly where I stand. Thank you very much.
Good evening, everyone. I'm so thankful that you all have come out to hear from us tonight. Thank you for everyone that is a part of this evening tonight and worked very hard to bring us to this point. My name is Michael McNeely. I'm running for chairman of the Georgia Republican Party. I want to share with you a little bit about me. I know many of you because I've been serving in the grassroots of this party for many years. But I just want to go over a little bit about my background and where how I got here today. I grew up in a little town called Rehm, Georgia. It's in Jefferson County near Augusta. Rural community with my mother and father. And I have a great mother and father because at 9 months old, they adopted me. And so the right to life issue is very important to me. And they taught me so many great things. My life has been focused on dedication to God and the country. I served in I was in the Boy Scouts and earned my Eagle Scout. I graduated high school. I went to George Southern University, earned a degree in criminal justice. Was a police officer for 14 years. Also served in the Georgia National Guard, Army National Guard. And I came to Atlanta serving in the Army National Guard. I'm currently an executive with a state agency of over 4,000 employees and a $325 million budget. In the party, I've served as Georgia Black Republican Council Chair. I was the political director for the Georgia Young Republicans, currently first vice chair, and I was third and first vice chair of my county in Douglas County. So, got a lot of experience both outside of politics and inside of politics. I work very, very hard to engage all communities, millennials, young people, minorities, and to grow our party and welcome everybody in. I remember when I first came to the party and nobody knew my name, I didn't know a soul, but I got involved because of the principles that I believe in. I'm both a fiscal and a social conservative. I stand on those principles. I work hard to help get Republicans elected to do the things that we all do so that our families can get the things that they need in life, not because of government, because of their own individual effort. I'm glad to be here today. I want to earn your vote to become the next chairman of the Georgia Republican Party. And again, thank you for being here tonight. And we've got a lot more to talk about, and I'll be glad to answer any questions and work with you to grow our party and ensure that we're on the standing that we need to, because we know some things are broken, but they're not insurmountable problems. We can fix them, and we will.
Good evening. My name is John Watson. Like the rest of these gentlemen, I'm a candidate for chairman of the Georgia Republican Party. Quick bit of background. I have been involved in Georgia Republican politics, campaigns, and the state party for nearly 25 years. My career in state politics began working for Congressman Bob Barr in the 1994 contract with America cycle. Many of you all remember that. I was Bob's finance director. After Bob's campaign, successful campaign, I was honored to be selected by Chairman Rusty Paul as the finance director of the Georgia Republican Party. I have been a professional fundraiser and have done so throughout my career. After that effort with Chairman Paul, I had the honor of being the campaign manager for Attorney General Mike Bowers in his effort for governor. After that, was able to be the chief, before that, had the opportunity to serve with Chairman Ralph Reed as the foundation chairman, again, running a fundraising organization. I was the chief political consultant and later chief of staff, Governor Sonny Perdue, when we accomplished the unthinkable, which was to take Georgia after 135 years of Democratic rule and turn it into Republican dominance. Of late, I've been the campaign chairman for David Perdue and his Senate effort. Ladies and gentlemen, the Georgia Republican Party is at a crossroads. Of late, we saw the fact that, unfortunately, in Cobb, in Gwinnett, and Henry, we lost on the presidential race. As importantly, and you all have seen the finances or heard about the finances announced in reference to it, but after 15 years of Republican dominance, the Democratic Party in Georgia has more money on hand than we do. It is frankly a disgrace, and we prepare for 2018, the critical election cycle ahead. If that continues, we have a chance of losing. Obviously, I have a background in finance, but as importantly, I have a long history of work with the grassroots conservatives that are this party. I've never been in a campaign whereby we did not cherish, embrace, support, and do everything necessary to be a grassroots campaign. I will continue to do as a chairman. I appreciate your time and the opportunity to be here this evening.
Evening. I think by now you know what office we're running for, so skip all that, get to something you don't know. That's a little bit about me. First of all, thank you so much for coming out tonight. It's just a wonderful joy to be back in the North Georgia Mountains. This is my birthplace. I was born just down the road in Clayton. Went to high school in DeKalb County and off to UGA with just about everybody else in my graduating class. I happened to catch my wife on the track, Susie Welsh. She started the women's track team at UGA, and that's where we met. And I have a degree there in finance. And then I liked it so much, went back, got another one in the county, and ended up with a child being born there, one of my four. Started with a daughter, and Alex, and then my son, Daniel, and they're married with children. In fact, today is a big day. We got to welcome my fourth granddaughter today, Ellie Grace, came at 9:06 this morning. My son Samuel couldn't be with us tonight. He's playing in a championship game of a basketball tournament, so he couldn't make it. But my daughter Grace is with us tonight. Grace is a really gorgeous girl, and inside and out. And she was the 2016 Tar of the Year. And last summer, she interned for Secretary of State Brian Kemp in his Corporations Division. And this coming summer, she'll be interning with Senator David Perdue up in Washington. Her desire is to work in the State Department and eventually go to this little country called South Korea. I have no idea why, but I thought Georgia was great. So anyway, after all that said and done, I got a good job and working for some big companies and doing a lot of things. And my main focus in my career is helping companies be lean, mean, and efficient. And that's exactly what I want to do for the Georgia Republican Party. I want to help this party be lean, mean, and efficient. And I have the skills and talents to do that. I'm looking forward to that opportunity. Thank you very much.
order at Waffle House as your default order. The All-Star Special is the rating.
We need a support.
We're now going to have a 3-minute close from everyone, and we're going to do it in reverse order. We'll start with Mike Welsh for a 3-minute close.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, tonight we've heard a lot of great questions, and we've heard a lot of great answers. But the bottom line is all just talk. So what really matters is trust. Who are you going to trust with this precious organization we call the Georgia Republican Party for the next couple of years? Who's going to care for it? It reminds me of the story of the guy walking down the beach and comes across this gentleman, and he's standing there in front of all these starfish that have been washed up. And he's reaching down and taking those starfish and chunking them out in the ocean one at a time. And the guy looks at him and says, "Are you crazy? What's the matter?" And he picks one down, and he reaches down and grabs it, throws it, says, "Matter to that one." Picks another one up, throws it in, says, "Matter to that one." Well, the bottom line is, you matter to me. And I hope to earn your trust as the next chairman of the Republican Party. Thank you.
Folks, thank you for being here. Thank you for the opportunity to address you. The Georgia Republican Party that we love, adore, and appreciate is not prepared to take on the responsibilities of 2018. We do not have adequate resources. We do not have the proper engagement of grassroots. We have lost our way. The reality is, I am the only former professional fundraiser on this stage. I am the only former field general that has run a campaign statewide and won. And we must admit, we must go on a wartime footing against our opponents as we prepare for 2018. As you discern, of which are all wonderful characteristics of the gentleman on this stage, you must discern the leader for the time that we find ourselves in. And I would ask for your support and humbly say that I fit the times the best. Thank you, and I hope everyone on this stage drives safely as we drove home to our families tonight. Sir.
The Georgia Republican Party is a grassroots organization. We need to work with our elected Republican officials. We need to work with people that can write the checks, but we should not be beholden to any of them. When we talk about what we need to do in our party, engaging minority communities, engaging millennials, listen, we can talk about it, but I've done that over the years. As political director of Georgia Republicans, Black Republican Council Chair, and helping candidates get elected just recently in this election cycle. When you talk about messaging and making sure that we get beyond the noise of the liberal media and articulating our message, I've done that. When you talk about supporting our candidates, Donald J. Trump, I dare you to find anything out there that does not support Donald J. Trump as first vice chair of this party when I did that. And I challenge you to look and see what all of us on this stage has done to support our now president of the United States. We've got to move forward. Our problems are surmountable, insurmountable, in a lot of regards to a lot of people. But I'm telling you today that we can overcome each and every one of them. We talk about the fundraising and finances. Listen, you got to stop bleeding. You got to have a budget. You got to not spend more than you bring in. That's fundamental to being a conservative. This isn't financial Armageddon. We can fix this. We're in a red state. We've got all elected officials at all levels that are Republicans. Now it's time to show leadership, being good fiscal stewards, and being able to command a room of grassroots warriors to continue to win for years to come. You've got a choice amongst us. Make the decision, but make it with all the facts, with everything on the table, understanding there are multiple issues that we need to face, and we've got individuals on the stage that can or cannot address those. You have to make that choice. And at any time for me, I can answer any of your questions anytime via cell phone, email, whatever you need. We can talk after because I'm here for you. And whatever happens at the end of the day, I'm a fiscal and social conservative, I'm a Georgia Republican, and we're gonna continue to win for years to come. Thank you.
Thank you all for having me here today. Thank you to my fellow candidates for coming and having a good debate.
What I'm here today to tell you is that, again, we need to be focused on our brand and party credibility. Those are the that's the most important thing, followed by growing county parties, focusing on the resources and training necessary to make it so we can grow a grassroots army, so that those 2 million Republican voters in this state, that not less than 1% knows about and is involved with the party. That we have at least 1% and hopefully 5 or 10% that know about us. Because right now, 2 million Republican voters, and we probably have less than 10,000 that are involved with us regularly. That needs to change. And that's what I will change as chairman. I am the only candidate that's been leading a statewide grassroots organization and growing it over the past year with 4 local chapters. I mean, it's grown from about 5 or 6 to over 150 people. That's what we've been doing around the state. That's what I've been doing to help out. I've been going to the Cobb County when the campaign was doing the primary, bringing people in, letting them know how to be involved in the party process and being delegates to conventions during the primary last year. There are between 75 and 150 Trump voters up in Cobb County coming a week to these meetings, not involved with the party. And no one from the party was there to bring them in. No one. I was bringing them. I was teaching them how to be involved. When Claire Harrison from Cobb County was running that group, she's the one who invited me to help do that. She did a great job coordinating Cobb County for Trump. And in the end, that's what we need. We need to be working with people and growing the party, working with the president, the volunteers of the presidential campaigns, not just the insiders, the political insiders, and the lobbyists and the consultants, but actually working with the grassroots, focused on the grassroots, because that's the only way the party will survive and thrive in the future, is by focusing on the people. I'm the only candidate that's been doing that. I'm the only candidate that's been sending out a newsletter for the past 4 years. You go to advancethegop.com, it will show you everything that I've thought, been talking about, and trying to bring people into the party for 4 years. Advancethegop.com, 4 years of history. You need someone credible, because every year people make the same promises in party leadership. But in the end, things don't seem to change. They've only gotten worse, is the question that earlier talked about. And the only way we're going to change things is by being a credible leader of the party who can walk into rooms and be credible with donors and let them know, hey, I'm the real deal. I'm not part of the old system, and I'm not beholden to anybody. We have a new vision. We're going to grow this army. We're going to grow the party. We're going to help county parties with everything they need in order to be successful. Because we need to be serving you, not the other way around.
Amen.
So, thank you all very much, and we'll be around for questions.
Thank you.